Head for big DIY country and don't miss the latest reductions in the big Texas sale. There's more reductions on garden furniture, on Black & Decker, more reductions on bedrooms, on kitchens, more reductions on paint and wall coverings, plus extra discounts on already low sale prices, like an extra 5% off these ladders, an extra 10% off these tables, an extra 20% off these shelves. And all these are still half price. Yes, half price in the big sale now on at Texas Home Care.
Mellow, satisfying St. Bruno. Flake already rubbed. A real pipe smoker's dream.
There is a card that does more than give you credit. It does you credit and shows you care. It's called the donor card, and it's like leaving new life to someone in your will. Pick up a donor card, and then keep it with you always, in a place where it can be found quickly. Carry the card. It shows you care.
Did you know?
Well, we're not blind, you know.
Recently, we have noticed that when you looked at Mum, you got a sort of soppy expression on your face. Had to be either love or indigestion.
It's the former, I'm glad to say.
Well, I'm glad you're taking it so well.
Of course, we weren't sure whether you'd get married or just live together.
You're all right, Dad. Better.
I don't see why you should be so shocked. I mean, after all, if things don't work out for you and Mum again, why should the only people who benefit be a farmer's solicitors?
Did you hear that, Beth? A 15-year-old child? What kind of moral standard
are you instilling? Oh, I don't think you should confuse morals with convention, Dad.
No.
I'll go. No, you see, it's not at all the same thing. We had to talk about this.
I think we'll talk about that later, actually. I bought you a little, well, it's a little...
Where's my birthday girl? Happy birthday. You two. Hello, Jane. Claire can't have all the kisses just because it's her birthday, can she, George?
No, of course she can't. When are you going to start kissing the rest of us?
Well, you're not really my type, old boy. Mind you, I might give Beth a big kiss when you're not looking. Just joking, old boy. Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, love.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Jenny, look, bow, wow, wow, Spandau Ballet, Stray Cats, Great Shaking Stevens.
It's a foreign language to me.
Let me get you a drink.
Oh, gin and tonic, please, plenty of ice.
Me too, please, we're absolutely gasping. We've been dry skiing this afternoon.
Oh, really? I thought you were concentrating on falling out of aeroplanes these days.
Well, that's Saturday afternoons, old boy. Saturday afternoons, we dry ski.
What do you do on Mondays? Get fired out of a cannon?
You've run out of ice.
I'll get it for you, darling. In fact, let me get the drinks.
Well,
we need more lemon. Look, Dad, you must know Shaking Steve. Is that for me?
Yes, well, I don't think you'd like it very much. I really shouldn't have got it, as a matter of fact, but I ought to have got you one of those shaking records, really, but...
May I see it?
Yes, please do. But if you don't like it, it doesn't matter. I can take it back to the shop and change it, so please don't...
Oh, Dad, it's lovely.
Do you like it?
Oh, thank you.
Do you really like it? But your mother said that you wouldn't, actually.
Mummy doesn't know everything. These days I'm more into the sort of new romantics, and this is perfect.
Really?
Punk's absolutely out now, you know.
Is it now? Goodness me.
How do I look?
Lovely. Now, you look absolutely lovely.
Oh, Dad. You are a nice old stick.
Beth! I'm a nice old stick.
Right. Shall I hold them in?
No. That's the garnish. Oh. Oh, I say it's look good, isn't it? It's a lovely colour. Very good on the nose, too. Oh, just taste that. Beautiful.
Need more bitters.
Ah! Oh, our married life. Nothing's ever been perfect. Too much bitters. Not enough bitters. Too much maraschino. Oh, our darling. Nobody could possibly drink that.
Oh. Shut up!
I got that wine cup. Haven't you finished it yet?
Try this.
You need more bitters.
That's what I said.
It does not need more bitters.
Look, George, let me finish making this. Look, George, if a thing's worth doing, it's worth doing properly.
Remind me that on the day of reckoning.
Now, I'll do it.
Look here, I've got...
Fill your wine cup, George.
A dash of cinnamon.
A dash of cinnamon?
Yep, cinnamon, Beth. Come on, chop, chop. Move over, old boy. A little bit more bitters.
Look, that...
Dash of this.
That is Mrs. Postgate's summer punch.
Mrs. Postgate?
Mrs. Postgate is also renowned for her green tomato chutney.
But who the hell is she?
An Indian Army colonel's lady, circa 1903. Thank you. Yeah. That's not the summer punch. It tastes more like cat's... Not very nice.
Answer the door, George. Come on, chop, chop. Oh. What do you think about this old girl?
George is right about one thing.
What?
It does taste like cat's pick.
Hello,
hey,
I'm Phil.
You go.
Right.
Oh, hello. You're Peter, aren't you? Would you like to come in?
Don't mind.
Well, the party's in here. Better come through. Come on into the drawing room.
Don't mind.
Jenny? Peter, I think. have you come to see Claire, then?
Don't mind.
Here you are. Wine cup at last. Ah. Would you like one?
Don't mind.
How many legs and how many breasts?
I beg your pardon?
The chicken, the barbecue's nearly up to heat.
George wants to know how many breasts and how many legs.
Usually two of each.
Chicken, Lord, hasn't he started barbecuing yet?
Well, the charcoal's not hot enough.
Well, blow on it.
Well, you come and blow on it. And if you see a St. Bernard dog with a barrel of brandy rats, next send him out here.
Darling, haven't you got a drink?
Drink as I have, but it's probably filled with tadpoles by now.
I'll send Bruce out with a scotch.
In that weather? You won't. I'll yell out of the window when I've got it, and you can come and get it.
Well, thank you very much. How many?
What?
How many pieces of chicken, for heaven's sake?
All right, George, no need to lose your cool.
Cool, that's the one thing I won't lose out here. Couldn't we just send out to the fish and chip shop or something for everybody?
The girls would be very disappointed.
Oh, I suppose so. Well, come on, then. How many breasts and how many legs do I have to do?
We'll do an assortment, and then after you finish the chicken, I'll hand you out the beef burgers.
And will I, by any happy chance of fate, be allowed back in again, then?
How do you feel about doing bananas in foil? On second thoughts, don't answer that, George.
Here we are. One scotch coming up the stoker. George! Come and get it. Good Lord. He's totally enveloped in steam. I suppose he does know what he's doing out there. You all right, old boy? You want a hand?
No, thank you very much. I'm perfectly capable of barbecuing a dozen pieces of chicken, thank you very much.
If you say so, old boy. Good luck. Mary Poppins.
Mum, can I have some more ice to throw in the wine cup, please?
Yes, of course you can, darling.
Poor old Dad. Oh. He is nice, isn't he?
Yes. Good heavens, who's that? I thought everyone was here.
A while ago.
How's the party going?
Oh, okay. But honestly, it is kid stuff, isn't it? Wine cup and chicken legs.
And what were you expecting? Hashish and hamburgers?
Well, it's Billy and Henry.
Oh, hello.
Hello. My goodness, what a day.
Wasn't it awful? We're just on our way to spend an evening with Henry's aged parents. Let it not be said I don't make sacrifices. So, on our way, we thought we'd drop in with Claire's birthday present. Happy birthday, darling.
Thanks.
Happy birthday, darling.
Mummy, look.
Ooh. Makes a change from Marks and Sparks.
Yeah.
Two pairs. Oh, thank you.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
You know what they say, good shoes and a handbag and you'll always feel elegant.
Personally, I've always thought wear a good pair of knickers and you can go anywhere.
Yeah. Can you stay for a drink?
Oh, perhaps a quick one.
Oh, Campari would be lovely. Thank you.
Scotch.
Oh, darling, darling, there's something horrible in the garden. That's George. Oh, is he? I thought he was a peeping Tom.
Oh. Can I have another scotch, please?
Why have you locked him out? He's barbecuing. In this weather, is he mad? Oh, well, each to his own taste. George, it's me, Millie.
Good Lord, it's you.
Oh, please, deserve it to see me. Oh,
Yes, but it's probably waterlogged by now.
Oh, Henry, be a dear. Get George another scotch.
Yeah, all right, I'll get it.
George, what I want to know is, why on earth are you barbecuing at this time of the year?
This time of the year, it's midsummer.
Midsummer? So it is, I keep forgetting. Oh, why don't you and Henry stay? We could easily barbecue another couple of bits of chicken, couldn't you, George?
If I stay out here any longer, I'll get webbed feet.
Sounds like fun. Shall we stay?
Oh, I don't know, Millie. Mummy and Daddy are waiting for us to make up at four at bridge. I mean, what would they do?
Play snap. Right, that's settled. We're staying.
Here you are. Pass it along.
Oh, here you are.
Yeah? Oh, bless you. Oh,
thank you, cheers.
Henry, why don't you take a turn at the barbecuing? Oh, come on, if we're staying, it's only fair.
No, I'm sorry, Millie, darling. It's George's children, George's children's barbecue. I wouldn't dream of...
I wouldn't mind, honestly.
Oh, I'm sorry, but I would.
Henry, if you'll take a turn at the barbecuing, oh, just for a little while, I'll...
Promise?
Oh, I promise. Wait till I get you home.
All right. Move over, George. Here I come.
Thank you very much, Henry. Gosh, it's... Sorry, decent of you. Here's my raincoat.
Thank you.
And there's the hat.
There's the hat.
Terrible weather, isn't it?
Oh, bottle of weather. We'll weather the weather whether we like it or not.
What exactly has Henry been drinking?
Promise.
Oh, I promise, darling.
Ranger.
Whatever he's been drinking, I don't think he'll have any more of it.
He hasn't been drinking. He's just very happy.
Well, I'm going out there. Why?
Let's just say rain starts play.
Well, I don't want to talk about, but I must say I'm extraordinarily grateful to him. It's absolutely freezing.
You should be extraordinarily grateful to me. I persuaded him. I thought he might make you a little nicer to me in future.
Nice to
meet
you. Yes.
Oh, sorry, old boy. Force of habit.
What do you want, darling?
We're all starving. Haven't you finished barbecuing?
No, but it's nearly ready now.
Thank goodness for that. By the way, remind me to show you my knickers.
What?
I won't be wearing them. They were a present from Millie.
I might have known you'd give her something like that.
George! I'm terribly sorry. It's gone out.
What?
I'm terribly sorry. It just sort of fizzled and died.
Look, give me my men. Of all the incompetent...
Well, I'm terribly sorry.
Well, I may be
it's
sorry.
All right. I expect your mind was on other matters.
Oh, yes, rather. Well, I
guess. Give me my hand. Have you got any paraffin anywhere?
Yes, there's some in the tool shed, but, George, I really don't think you should...
God, I've been to barbecue those chicken legs. It was the last thing that I'd do.
Well, if you're going to use paraffin, it may well be.
Could I have a shake of your vinegar?
What? Oh.
You've got haddock or skate. Oh. Scampi.
Oh. Hi, everybody. Ready at last.
Oh. Oh, darling. The party's nearly up and going home.
Going home? No, fish and chips. You know, it's not very easy being a father.
Nobody ever said it was, darling.
Deja vu is nothing new, though read before. It seems I've heard those loving words somewhere before. And love's old song drips from a tongue I've long forgotten. Every time I look into
entertainment in style. ITV in view.
Tell you what, sport. For more of a kick to results and reviews, for weather or not, you're about to brave the elements.
For a recipe a day to starve you of boredom.
Got any more, Mum?
Page the Oracle.
For figures, facts, fun, frolics, and 30 pages of the very latest down-to-earth, up-to-the-minute news, page the one who knows, page the Oracle.
All right, sport.
It's your last chance for final reductions at Queensway's Big Q Sale. The Caravelle Double Draw Divan, down to half price. £100 off this Radler bedroom fitment. £80 off the Linton dining unit. The Carolina three-piece lounge suite, half price. Axminster's half price. Free fitting on giant carpet stocks. It's your last chance for final reduction in Queensway's Big Q sale. Everyone's a winner, baby.
I always pick a long life when I've mown the grass.
Don't allow another beer to lead you up the garden path. That would be like spraying your dahlias with Dennis dust. Like allowing your roller to rust. Like feeding your marrows till they're fit to bust. You see, any other beer is simply out of place. You can't expect another beer to match this taste. Cause long life's specially brewed for the can.
There's so much more than TV Times in TV Times magazine.
This Saturday night at 6:45, Bob's Your Uncle with Family Fortunes.
100 people surveyed, there are 6 answers to be found, and hit the button when you're sure you have an answer. Name a famous fictional detective.
Name him.
Hercule Poirot.
Hercule Poirot, the famous Belgian created by Agatha Christie.
Well, at 7:15, comedy's the name of the game with Russ Abbott.
You're a big boy, aren't you?
Hey. Just watch it, Sancho. Well, now, we've got a letter here from teeny, teeny me, from a 15-year-old Nigel Farrington Smythe. Ooh, what a wonderful name. That's a hype.